Yeah, hi everyone. I just want to show you my new native watercraft Slayer Propel 10. I've had it for about 6 months and I just want to show you how I fitted it out. One thing I do when I fitted it out, I want to make sure I didn't want to drill any holes and I wanted to make sure everything was easy to detach and strong. So first of all, I'll just show you how I've some of the mounts that I've made. If you see here, these are my rod mounts. They're it's about 5 mil thick aluminium plate that is nice and light, won't rust. And I've painted all black so it matches in nice. So I've got a plate for my rod holders, one each side, one over here, one over here. A big plate here for my fish finder, and another one here for the transducer. The bolts I used, I didn't want to go for the ball mounts and all that because these are so much stronger. But if you have a look, they're I use 25 mil nuts and wing nuts on a 25 mil bolt. And if you have a look, they fit absolutely perfect into the track. So that's what I've got here. On the bottom of the aluminium plates, I've stuck some thin layer of rubber. That helps protect the aluminium scratching the rail, but also helps suck the pull tight, and it gives a really strong fit. So if I ever want to move anything, it's as simple as just loosening wing nuts and sliding along. I can slide them out the end of the track if I want, put two rod holders on one side. If I want to move the fish finder around, I can put it up the front, over the other side, whatever I want. So that's why I've done it like that. Just push it, wind them down nice and tight, and that locks, that's not going anywhere. So to also, here's all the gear I carry around. I like to keep it everything nice and neat, a bit of a neatness freak. So I'll put it together and show you how it all goes together. That's my trolley that I made, nice and easy. Just sits up underneath the transom holes at the back. Nice and easy to fit, no need to tie anything down. So I'll put my propeller system in, lock that in. Right, next I like my oars at the back out of the road. So I put a couple of oar holders at the back, each side. Most of the travelling I do is via the Propel system. Okay, next I've got this box. Cost me about $15 down at the local hardware store. I like this idea rather than a crate because everything stays nice and dry. So put this up on the mat. So on the side, I've made some little bungee cords. I just hooked in with those little plastic loops. Made some nice short bungees. Snap it down, keep it in nice and tight. Two each side. All nice center, that's not going anywhere. But on the side here, you'll see I've put an old rod holder here as a keeping my knife in. Makes it nice and easy, not going to cut my hand when I'm grabbing in the box. And also on the front, I've put an old rod holder here where I keep my pliers, nice and easy to grab. Right, so in the box, lid up here, my everything box. So you see at the front, I have my battery for the fish finder in there. So here's my transducer. If you have a look at the transducer, it's made out of about 15 mil PVC and I've painted it black. On the end, you see there at the end, I heated it up and squashed it, and it's squashed really well, made it all melted together, make it all watertight. And I've cut it on an angle but also made it a little bit longer than where the transducer comes down, and that way if I go over any stumps or hit anything, it'll hit the PVC rather than the transducer. So that just simply just pushes in the side, whoop, like that. All the spare cord for the fish finder goes underneath. Fish finder I use, I have a Lawrence hook felt for with chirp. Great little fish finder. And I'll put that mounts on the front there like that. So as you can see, no need to drill any holes, it all just sits nicely there. That'll end up under the seat. You see it's just I've wrapped it up and covered in duct tape. I could have had that in the box, but I found it was just easier just to have the one lead going into the side of the box rather than having the two. Okay, my seat. I think these are I've had a couple of kayaks and this is by far the best seat I've ever experienced on a kayak. There's bungee hooks in there. As you see then, all the cable for the fish finder's out of the road. I have two bungee cords on the back here, so a green one I have for my fishing rods that hook each side, another one under here that I've made up with some ties on the end, they just go onto my oars. There's nothing worse than you're paddling away, going to reach for your paddles and one of them's missing. Simply slide on like that, that way I won't lose my paddle, got one of them for each side. The other one goes to the rods. I've got this, made this bungee out of whippersnipper cord. I got that for my front hatch. Here's my net. Even though the net comes with a bungee, they don't reach very far and they do tend to snap the elastic. So with this on here, it gives me much more reach to be able to grab the fish, and that just simply sits up there. My rod holders, one each side. Seat back to where it goes. Now I do a lot of trolling, so I like to have a fishing rod holder each side, but I could have two to one side if I ever pull up, but I like one each side. And you see how strong they are, they're not going. I catch mull away and all sorts on that, and they don't move, and I can put them on different angles if you want. I'm going to play the game today, so yes, have it on, move it wherever you want, several different angles, nice and strong. And the other benefit of what I've done here is that when I get into the shallows, I have having the transducer next to me, I just pop it out and simply just set up behind me. Easy as that. When I get out in the deep, reach around and pop it back into place. And that's really, really strong. So just going through what else I have in my bucket of good. I always have a couple of chopping boards. So that costs a couple of dollars from the supermarket. Always have some nylon chopping boards because you know, shouldn't be cutting bait up on the side of your boat. It's not the best thing for it. And the old, a cooler bag. That's great for just having your drinks in and putting your fish, keeping them fresh. And of course, you have a measure, torch, and when you're in a kayak, it's always good to be hands-free. So the good old headlamp. And as you can see, all nice and neat when I'm out in the boat. So you see, that's how I'm fully set up. I do not drill any holes in the boat. Everything's nice and convenient, very, very strong. And when I'm finished, I pack it all up. I can mount it on the top, travel for a couple of hours and not have to worry about bits and pieces blowing off my kayak. It all packs away nice and neat. It's all stored together. So hope you enjoyed the video and learned some things of what I've done, and happy kayaking. Thank you.